Hey everybody, today we are going to make Gordon Ramsay's vegan BLT. He just released this recipe for this rice paper bacon, which we've done here many times, but he's added a cool little trick that I just had to try out. So first, let's put together the marinade for the bacon. We're going to start with some sriracha, nutritional yeast, aka nooch. It's good to know that Gordon follows the vegan law with this recipe. And then we're going to do some garlic powder and some cayenne powder, smoked paprika for some smokiness, and then also liquid smoke for some smokiness as well, and then a whole bunch of maple syrup, some soy sauce naturally, then some melted vegan butter, followed by some dihydrogen monoxide, aka water, and then a few shakes of black pepper. We'll give that a mix, and then next, let's get some tofu, which has been pressed for about 1 hour. In his recipe, Gordon calls for it to be pressed overnight, but that seems a little excessive. I've never pressed it for more than an hour, and I found that to be totally sufficient. Either way, we're going to crumble about 3 ounces, and then we'll get some more nooch and some of that marinade in there, and then we're going to mix that up, and we're going to let that hang out for a bit while we prepare our rice paper bacon. And now we'll get some scissors and cut out bacon-sized strips, like so. And I was definitely having first-grade flashbacks of cutting construction paper at this point. But once all of our strips are cut, we'll get 2 rimmed sheets, one filled with water, the other one with our marinade. And then we're just going to simply hydrate our strips until they are pliable. And then after that, we're going to add them to the marinade and get them all nice and coated. And after that, let's throw them on a cutting board. And now, here's the cool trick by Gordon. We're gonna take some of that crumbled tofu and add it on top of one of our bacon strips. And then, once we got a good amount in there, we'll take the other strip and press it down to sandwich the tofu inside. And this is gonna create some chewier bits in the bacon and really give it some depth. And now, while I can admit that this is a cool technique, it is also quite time consuming. As with other rice paper bacon recipes, it can get quite tedious hydrating and marinating individual strips. I only made about half of the recipe and it was taking upwards of an hour for just this part. So I tested out my technique where I use an entire sheet so as to speed up the process. So basically you do the exact same thing, but with the entire sheet. And then we'll lay it down and add some rows of the crumbled tofu, like so. And we'll sandwich that with another sheet, making sure to press down and get all the air bubbles out of there. And then we'll just simply slice our bacon strips like this, and bam, we have a bunch more bacon in way less time. Now, in the original recipe, Gordon calls for you to bake the bacon, and then halfway through, you're supposed to scrunch it with your fingers to get curly bacon, which sounded slightly dangerous and like something I didn't want to do, so instead I used these metal straws, and that turned out to be a good move. So, we'll lay that bacon on those metal straws, and then we're gonna bake it at 375 degrees Fahrenheit for 10 to 12 minutes, and then we're gonna check on it. And while that's happening, I'm gonna show you how I failed at making an aioli, but don't worry, I'll show you how I made an amazing sandwich spread that was probably just as good, if not better. So in his recipe, Gordon takes some Just Egg and emulsifies it with some avocado oil. And I've never done something like this, and I thought I followed the instructions, but according to my buddy Sauce Stash, who also filmed a video for this recipe, and by the way, go check his video out too. Anyway, according to him, he made it successfully by adding the oil extremely slowly, like a drip at a time. So I reckon I just added mine too quickly. He said it took him about 10 minutes, which if I had known that's how long it would take, I wouldn't have bothered as I'm way too lazy. So as you can see here, I tried it in both my Vitamix and my food processor and it never got thick. Total waste of oil and Just Egg. So if you're lazy and unskilled at aiolis like me, just get some vegan mayo. I'm using about a cup here. And then we're gonna add in some freshly zested lemon and some chopped basil, and then some minced garlic, freshly squeezed lemon juice, some Dijon mustard, some freshly ground black pepper, and then finally some sprinkling salt. And then we'll mix that up. And I gotta say, this was probably my favorite part of this whole recipe. This spread was so zip-zapping good, you gotta make this too. And now our bacon is done. And I believe I had to bake this for like 15 extra minutes. So it took about 45 minutes just to bake it. And some of them were still a little floppy. For reference, in my rice paper bacon recipe, you just fry them in a pan and they are done in a few minutes and you can make them as crispy or chewy as you like. I'm just saying. But now all we gotta do is put together our sandwich. So let's get some heirloom tomatoes. And by the way, I love these tomatoes. I can eat them like apples. I'll just take a bite out of them. And now let's get our bread. The original recipe calls for vegan brioche, but I wanted to keep it classy. So I got some lightly toasted Texas toast. And we'll slather on a good amount of our lazy person's aioli, which is just as good and in less time, so it's really a smart person's aioli too. And next, our lettuce to make it healthy, followed by our delicious tomatoes, which you should salt, of course. And then a few strips of our vegan bacon, and then our top piece of toast, which I later slathered with more of our smart person's aioli too. And now it's time to do a taste test, and in a Burger Dude first, I'll be talking to you in real time as I take a bite.
Mmm. Oh, wow. The aioli is what's kind of really coming through, especially the lemon and the garlic. The bacon, on the other hand, I'm not sensing a huge difference between his bacon and my bacon. So let's try his bacon just by itself. You can see the tofu going through the middle. Let's just give this a try. It's good. It's not bad. The tofu in the middle does create a nice contrast of the chewy kind of center, and then the outside's crispier. I just don't think it's worth all the effort. And considering that his bacon takes a lot longer to make, there's a lot more room for error, mine's just easier. I know I'm biased, but I'm also right. Make my rice paper bacon. I'll leave a link right here. And if you do make it, let me know how it goes. And I hope you're all doing great, and I'll see you all next time.